Well, Vice President-elect Duterte will sit as Education Secretary under the Marcos administration. Let's now talk with Benjo Basas. He's the Teachers Dignity Coalition's national chairperson to tell us what the education sector expects of the new DepEd chief. Benjo, good afternoon and thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, yes, Ms. Rain, good afternoon at good afternoon po sa viewers natin, listeners.
You have a wish list for the incoming education chief, Sara Duterte Carpio. Can you kindly share with us what this looks like?
Yes, ma'am. No, of course, we call it wish list. No, but of course, this is also the 13-point teacher's dignity agenda that we presented to the candidates during the campaign period for this 2022 elections. No, and of course, no, since Inday Sara won the vice presidency, and surprisingly, she will also sit as the DepEd chief, the secretary of the Department of Education. So primarily, sa kanyang opisina namin ito dadalahin. Our agenda is composed mainly of items for the teachers' welfare, and then second is welfare of children and the need for learning, and lastly the change in curriculum. So these are the three main features of our 13-point teachers dignity agenda. Of course, on top of that is our request, our overdue demand for salary increase or at least a just compensation package, as we call it.
Does it include anything on face-to-face classes versus work from home? Perhaps teachers' welfare and training. On top of that, was there any indication of how teachers or at least your group would like to see the mandatory military training that Ms. Duterte Carpio has already hinted at?
Okay, ma'am. Of course, we are anticipating face-to-face classes, the return to physical or in-person classes by next school year, and we assume that a particular matter has been agreed upon by the transition teams of both parties of the outgoing and incoming DepEd management. Of course, in terms of face-to-face classes, basic naman yung aming sinasabi ever since yung ligtas na balik eskwela. Of course, it includes the package for water, sanitation, disinfection facilities for children, the reduced number of children in classroom operation, in classroom learning. Of course, the assistance for our teachers in terms of technology, basically, technology, laptop, computer, internet, connectivity, so and of course, yung physical, facilities, sa ating mga paaralan, and then as to the mandatory military training, madam, as of now, hindi pa naman kami nag-come up into definite position on that, but initially, hindi naman namin nakikita na there is a necessity for this, at hindi rin ito namin nakikita sa lens ng education sector, we do not consider this an urgent matter to be acted upon by our incoming DepEd secretary.
I don't know if you were able to catch it, Benjo, but we just heard the incoming vice president say that she, as DepEd chief, would like to focus on a pagbabago campaign, a change campaign among the students, as well as a responsible parenthood among the parents of the students. Is this something that perhaps your 13-point agenda or your wish list would actually synchronize with?
Hindi namin alam yung specifics po nito, of course I heard her statement earlier, pero hindi pa rin kasi natin nakita ano ba yung mga particulars tungkol dito, of course, yung pagbabago campaign, we really don't know, kasi part of our agenda is the change in curriculum. no, and our change in curriculum is towards the strengthening of let's say, for example, human rights education, culture, no, indigenous people's education, you know, peace, no, peace education, you know, and of course, no, the strengthening of Philippine history, and culture, literature and culture, no, and of course, languages, no. So mukhang doon namin siya tinitingnan, na we really don't know, no, kung anong direction, no, papunta itong itong kampanya para sa pagbabago ng ating incoming secretary. But nevertheless, no, we are willing to engage her, no, in a dialogue, in a meeting, and of course, no, we are willing to collaborate, no, for those agenda or for those plans, no, or programs that we might think, no, na makatulong naman, no, ito sa ating mga bata sa education sector.
Benjo, given the local government experience of incoming Vice President Duterte Carpio and not as closely in the education sector, what will you be watching out for? Are there particular risks or threats to you that, or maybe even opportunities that you see with her entering the education sector?
Well, we could say, no, na yung experience niya, no, in terms of education sector ay limited, no. But of course, no, that would also be, you know, the assessment, no, sa iba naman, ano, ng mga politicians, no, na umupo as Defense Secretary, no, hindi naman din siya ang first politician, no, I would say, no, na umupo as secretary. No, in the past, meron po tayo mga in fact sitting Congress men, no, na kinuha, no, at in-appoint as Defense Secretary, no. And at the same time, no, of course, no, yung experience niya naman, ano, sa I think, no, one of the biggest matter, no, that has to be resolved in education sector is the management, eh, no. So sobrang laki po nito, no. Well, you could just imagine, no, how big the deficit is, no, considering that we have almost a million personnel, no. So yung I think, no, edge, no, for Inday Sara, yung kanya experience, no, sa management, no, sa local government, no, especially of course, no, Davao, no, Davao City being the third largest city, no, sa ating bansa, no, at perhaps, no, we could consider this as opportunity then, no, na a sitting vice president, no, will soon be the Secretary of Education. This is the first time, no. Ibig sabihin po niya, no, everything, no, na may kinalaman sa DepEd or may kinalaman sa education sector is a big thing, no. Everything would be a national matter, no, national a matter of national interest, no, kasi the vice president is the head of the Department of Education, and we consider that, no, somewhat an opportunity for us. Ibig sabihin po yung mga issues ng education sector ay hindi na ito mababaliwala, no, and one thing more, no, we know, no, naman, ano, yung reach, no, ng influence ni VP elect Sara Duterte, di ba? Kaya niya siguro, no, na not to compel, no, but to influence, no, the decisions of the legislature. Now basically yung aming hinihingi po na 13 point teachers agenda, no, most of those items are actually to be legislated po.
All right. Meanwhile, Benjo, we have many schools deciding to proceed with face-to-face classes in the coming school year, some of them hybrid. And you are questioning this executive order of the DepEd, which takes away the vacation of teachers in favor of Brigada Escuela. Plus, we have an EO on mandatory remedial classes or enrichment classes for students who did poorly in the last academic year. Can you kindly share with us your thoughts on these EOs?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, no, for that question.
Benjo, so it seems that we have lost Benjo Basas of TDK. We'll try to get him back in the coming minutes.
Hello?
Yeah, Benjo. Okay, good, you're back. Yes, we lost you there for a moment. Yes, the question on... of course, face-to-face classes, but first, your summer will be spent still working.
Yes, no. Well, surprisingly, no. The memo was released, no, 2 weeks ago, no, last week, no, And medyo nagulat po kami, no, dahil it was an issue once, no, by the outgoing, no, DepEd management. And then the implementation would fall, no, under the new DepEd secretary or DepEd leadership, no. But then ano, yung aming release na issue dito is we have, no, teachers are entitled, no, to 60-day vacation, no, 60-day school break, no. Supposedly hindi yan mababawasan, no. But with that memorandum, with that order from the Department of Education, no, they are going to take away 15 days, no, from our teachers, no. But still, no, we are not actually, no, we are totally opposed, no, to this idea, no, kasi of course, no, baka naman yun pong ating mga bata, no, some of our learners, no, would need, no, these remedial classes, no. By the way, ma'am, this is composed of two kinds of classes, eh, ano po, no. One is the remedial, that is for children na medyo meron tayong a failing grade, no, at least two failed marks, no. And then another is the enrichment classes, no, na para naman dun sa mga bata na ang grade nakakuha ng low grades, no, like 75 to 79, which actually a passing grade, a passing mark, no. Kaya nga sabi namin, ano, bakit pa natin pabalikin yung bata, eh nagsikap na nga siya, no, or at least yung teacher ay kinonsider na, no, well, two-way po yan, ano po, yung magulang niya rin ay nagsikap na rin, ano, para makapasa, makakomply yung bata sa requirements, no, nung subject na yan, ano, for that particular grade level. And yet at the end of the day, pababalikin mo pa rin pala, no, for 15 days, no. Sabi namin baka maging relevant din ito, no, dahil lang ang sinasabi naman din ng DepEd, ito ay voluntary on the part of the parents, no. But nevertheless, no, again, ano, ang aming issue pa rin dito ay wala ditong malinaw, no. Well, the issue of compensation is not embedded in this order, no. So we might assume, no, we assume, no, na wala pong compensation dito, no. And this is a work or duty beyond our normal teaching duties, beyond our what is expected, no, of us as a public school teachers po, no, who supposedly, no, will serve, no, for only 10 months, no, because Ms. Shane, no, wala po kaming ano, wala kaming vacation and sick leave, no. All the government workers and even the employees and workers in private sector, no, only the public school teachers po, no, do not enjoy this kind of leave of absence po.
Well, hopefully that gets addressed by the outgoing as well as the incoming DepEd management. Benjo Basas of the Teachers Dignity Coalition, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you, ma'am.